Within 3 miles, we'd hit 260 miles an hour. Takes the Bugatti Veyron 5. That tells you how good these engines are. Unbelievable.
So what you're saying is you don't have the balls to turn it up?
Have a hernia.
So tomorrow when we turn it up, you're gonna do 300?
Yeah, why not? Yeah, I'll give it a shot.
Yeah. Looking for the camera. For the camera, it's a different story, right?
Yeah, no, wait. Now cut.
427 cubic inch small block, twin turbocharged, 2 injectors per cylinder, intercooled. Crank trigger, ignition, Nelson Racing. Designed for Anthony Keating and his crazy supercars. 1,655 horsepower, 1,614 foot-pounds, 5,300 RPM. We shut the pull off early at 5,500. Because the boost level was 36 pounds, and it started going a little lean. It's almost 4 horse per cubic inch. This is an animal. Anthony Keating Supercars is going to have one of the fastest cars in the world. This is a 632 cubic inch big block Chevy, 9.5 to 1 compression, killer mean street engine. Definitely got a nasty little idle, good little piece. We'll put a titanium rod in this, so the bob weight on this motor is only about 2,000 grams, so it's comparable to small block Chevy, but in a 600 inch motor. So it's just a super accelerator.
The latest pull. 785 foot-pounds, 837 horsepower, 91 octane.
Got a pump gas Warrior 632 in this. Today what we're looking at is one of our 572 Warrior series. These are like heavy duty race engine, super reliable, 2500 horsepower. Today this one's making 2300 horsepower at a relatively low boost. It's got our billet 16 injector intake with the fuel regulation built in, and we've got it flipped 180 degrees. So the throttle body is pointing toward the back. And on this application, since it's going into a race car, we've got a water to air intercooler. So we've stacked 2 cores together. Water cools the core, and then the pipes go in through the bottom of the intercooler, or actually into the top of the intercooler, and then out of the bottom into the throttle body itself. So we got 1,340 peak foot-pounds with 1,490 peak horsepower,
at 27, 28 ish pounds of boost, pretty conservative tune up. Another 10 pounds to go.
So we're looking at our 427 twin turbo hot rod series small block, the workhorse of the bunch. It's got the twin blow off valves and our little billet snout piece holding the blow offs, our water to air intercooler setup. And this is the new one with the AFR 235 head. This is for our customer George in Romania, going in an Ultima GTR. Pretty wild little motor. Over 1700 horsepower at high boost. All right, today we're going to be videoing one of our latest creations. This is a Nelson 32 valve dual overhead cam small block, basically. We've cut this motor from a solid chunk of metal, and I'm really pretty proud of this thing. It's a Y block design, cross bolt main with billet steel caps. It's got a priority main oil system built into it. It's got chain drive, so drives the cams with the chains. Ductile iron sleeves, full water. For a billet block, it's got full water. And we can build this motor as big as 500 inches in a small block form. Here's a shot of where we would locate the cam tensioners and chains and etc.
horsepower. It's only at 16 pounds of boost right there. How crazy is that?
Considering this is the first time starting it up, the engine sounds really good.
horsepower, 976 foot-pounds at the wheels at only 22 pounds of boost. Code Red is alive and well.
Right now, this motor on the dyno is capability of making over 1,500 horsepower.
1,000 dyno pulls later, give you an idea of how insane this motor is held together. Take a look at these bearing shells. So I wanted to give you guys a bird's eye view of what this intake looks like, apart. So basically, we removed the plenum lid of the alien intake here. And as you can see, we've got really nice radiuses going into the port itself. So the airflow, and the nice thing about CNC machining, you can see there's just no mismatch going on there. So the airflow has a really nice smooth transition into each runner. Plus, each runner's a nice straight shot.
This is our new 428 cubic inch twin turbo Ford based. It's a Ford based off of a Windsor. This package fits in a early Mustang, 67, 69s. It's a really nice combination. 1,000 horsepower on pump gas, makes 1,500 horsepower on race gas.
This is our all aluminum 572 cubic inch twin turbo Chrysler Hemi.
This is the twin turbo 572 Chrysler Hemi. It's an all aluminum engine. It's got our half billet intake on there, 16 injectors, octane on demand. And what this is an intercooled 1071 blown 427 inch small block, all the great stuff in it. And as you can see, it makes close to 800 horse at low boost, and you know, close to 950 at relatively mild boost. So it's just a combination that's just super nasty. It's made for a guy that he likes something that's like a time bomb, you know, just a firecracker at idle. You just breathe on the throttle, it goes nuts. So this is for that guy.
So we've got the vacuum ports on the outside, so it looks like it's alcohol injected, like the old gassers. But on the inside, we've got electronic control with, you know, new controls.
AKA Smurf juice, the button, the unit, whatever you want to call it. But it's really pretty cool because it takes a, you know, a good running motor and makes it into just an insane motor.
This is a street motor. This is our hot rod series. It's got a 1471 billet blower, dual 1000 Hollies, CNC ported Brodies, Big M Dart block, all the good stuff. Just a menacing, crazy looking motor.
Go take it for a drive, see how she sounds. Of course, that's the best thing. This thing does sound mean.
8 individual throttle bodies. Kinzer made a part number 001 for him. 8 individual coils, so coil per cylinder.
Series.
So here is Stacy Belante's 572 fuel injected hot rod series NRE style.
NASCAR's running in the background.
Twin turbocharged 427 cubic inch LSX motor. We've got this going into a Musler, which is a 2400 pound mid-engine car, all carbon fiber rims, you name it. So this is our 572 hot rod, our new hot rod engine, and it's built to handle the nitrous. So this is a 1,000 horsepower deal, really good bang for the buck. And 763 horsepower is what it's making on the motor. And 1482 horsepower, 1440 foot-pounds on race gas, and there's a lot more in this motor.
I'm David Freiberger, editor-in-chief of Hot Rod Magazine here at Nelson Racing Engines in Chatsworth, California. We just made 1480 horsepower with this thing, which was unreal. Just a 408 cubic inch motor. We're actually gonna dial it back down to 1000 horse and drive it on drag week.
Right, here's that pump. Take off. Oh my god. All you see is black stripes and plenty of smoke.
So this is a 540 cubic inch big block Chevy. It's got an F2 Pro Charger. So this is our F2 Pro Charger hot rod series. Turbocharged 427 cubic inch small block, making 1100 horse on pump, 1750 horsepower race gas. We've got two huge air to airs, a large water radiator, and what's even crazier about this is it's got a sequentially shifted 5-speed transaxle.